Hi everyone, thank you for joining the DroidCon, this great event. Today we will explore it with HMS technically. So, just brief information about me. Oops. Okay. Today, currently I'm leading the DTSE team in Italy. DTSE is a developer technical support engineer. Our mission, our focus is on supporting developers and partners integrating HMS into their projects. So our mission is to reduce the effort integrating our services to be on board on AppGallery, our store. So these are a lot of contacts to contact me. So please do it. About this year, starting from the version 4.0.0, we have created a lot of kits, up to 56. Just starting with the account kit is the first kit that we have. It's just like a social network kit, just a button, auto-managed button to log in with the Huawei ID. It's very easy for the user to log in into an app through its Huawei ID. And it's very easy for a developer. About the other kits, we have also components just like audio kit, video kit. Video kit is just like a video player, just like EXO Player from Google, but our video kit is a component that you can use. So all our kits are meant to reduce your effort integrating something in your app. About the HMS Core, and about what it's around HMS Core, because we have also DGX Lab tools, a lot of tools about just like toolkit, Huawei toolkit, to convert your already GMS dependencies to HMS dependencies, and so on. We have the Huawei Assistant, cloud debugging, and so on. And also we have a lot of events about the Huawei Developers Day and also the contest live here in these days, the Apps Up 2020 contest. HMS Core is a wrapper of services and it's already installed on all Huawei devices, but you can install, of course, also on other Android devices starting from 4.4. And you can download it through Google Play, but we suggest to download AppGallery through the official website and download the HMS Core from there. Just because of the version on Google Play is old. The version of HMS Core on AppGallery is very recent, so we suggest it. About the frameworks, our frameworks is on Android Native, of course, but our focus is also on other frameworks, just like Flutter is a very recent framework, and React Native, Xamarin, Cordova, Ionic, and so on, but also game frameworks, just like Unity, DGDX, Cocos. Unity, we have two integrations. We have the official plugin through open source plugin through GitHub, Unity plugin for HMS, but also we have Unity Distribution Portal integration. It's an official integration, and it's very easy to integrate in App Purchase through it. Also, DGDX, I wrote personally two articles on Medium and also on our Huawei Developer Forum in order to integrate in App Purchase again services on through DGDX. Also, Cocos, you know that Cocos is with C++, so you can create a bridge through C++ and Android Native kits, but we have also the official integration into the IDE Cocos Creator. This is an hero case with the Unity distribution portal Spingram. It's one of 20 finalists of UpsUp 2020 contest, and you can explore it on AppGallery, of course. This is integrating both account kit and also in a purchase. How to test it? You can test it through our tools, of course, your devices, of course, but our tools on developer console, just like cloud testing and cloud debugging. Cloud testing is to automate testing on your app. But cloud debugging is just like an emulator, but it's not a real emulator because it's a real device hosted from remote. So you can choose your device, your preferred device, and then you can build your app and check the logs. We have also cloud debugging for Android Studio, so you can use it through the Huawei Toolkit. Huawei Toolkit is a plugin from Android Studio, but also you can download it from the official website of Huawei developers. I want to highlight the main kits, the most common kits. We have a lot of kits, but we highlight only some, the most common kits. Analytics and crash service. Crash service is a crash reporting service. You know it's very important to have into your app in order to monitoring the crash status live from the users. But is strictly related to analytics. So you have to implement also analytics and crash service. But you need those only the implementation, the Gradle implementation, and nothing more. You don't need to write code for automatic collection. Obviously, you can create custom events through analytics kit. If you want to auto-collect data, you just have to implement TruthGradle. About Huawei Analytics, what you can do is a lot of things. Just like funnel is very common feature. But also you can check the retention. You can check a lot of way to do analytics with your app. But also analytics is integrated with our services, just like DTM is Dynamic Tag Manager. If you want to redirect analytics events through the Dynamic Tag Manager to another dashboard, just like Google Analytics, you can. And also crash service, as I said before. Also A/B testing, you can do it. About the crash service, we have a method, we have a function to test it, but you can generate an null pointer by yourself, you know. About our console. Our console is very complete because you can also check your mapping file. Because if you're obfuscating code, you need to upload your mapping file, you know. And you can check the stack trace and also device model and device information. But you can also add a filter not only for models, but also for user ID. So you can link your user ID through analytics, and crash service will get that user ID. If you don't want to track analytics data, but you want to track crash reporting, you can do it. You can disable at runtime analytics. But the crash reporting is still working. This is the way to analyze a stack trace. You see. In this case, it's a null pointer. About another kit, location kit is very famous kit, is very common kit. Our three features for location kit are fused location, activity identification, and geofence. With fused location, you can check the location request, you can check the location in real time, in a lot of situation, also into a structure, an infrastructure. About activity identification, you can check what a user is doing. If he is using, if he's using sensor and so on, but also geofence. If you're interested in an area, you can check status of this area through push notification. About the integration, it's a very common integration because if you already use the Fuse API location from Google, you're very familiar with this integration. This is from Android Open Source Project. You know that you have to check the permission in the manifest, but starting from Android Q, if you want to track the background location, you have to add also a line for access background location in manifest. And of course, starting from Marshmallow, you need to check the permission at runtime. And of course, starting from Android Q, you have to check also for background location at runtime. And so, or request permission result, you can check the permission. If a user has cancelled or has granted a permission, you can check it through FIT. It's all from Android Open Source Project. It's not strictly related to HMS. So if you're familiar with location services in general, you can do it. You already know that. About our HMS location kit, you just have to integrate a fused API location provider client. So you can check the settings for this client. You can add settings and check if a user has already enabled the geolocation. Then you can set the priority for high accuracy or low accuracy, and also the interval for location request. We can support also the get last location. If you already have asked for a result and already got a result for location request, you will have also a last location. So you will get a last location in a very easy and fast way. About always our AppSup 2020 contest finalists in Europe, these are our three finalists, three Italian apps that are integrating location kit, BigLens, Earthquake Network, and Custom Widget Maker. So you can check it through FAP Gallery. About MapKit and SiteKit. MapKit and SiteKit are not strictly related, but you can find all the information about point of interest and also map with through both of them. Because with MapKit you can support different routes. You can support 180 million POI information and so on. We're covering a lot of countries with MapKit. And there through TomTom. So about SiteKit, you can search results by keyword. You can find nearby location, and also you can use the geocoding, inverse and positive geocoding. You can do it also with Android Open Source Project, but with SiteKit, it's very easy and faster. And this is an example of our MapKit. This is through the map view. We support both map view and map fragment. So you can add simply the map view in your layout. You can use a constraint layout. You can use whatever for a layout. And then you can add the customization for this map view. If you will integrate the map view, you have to check the life cycle of the map view. If you integrate the map fragment is already managing the life cycle of the map view. So it's faster with the map fragment, but we are giving you all the choices. You have to choose the best for you. It's up to you. And this is the way to check the life cycle of the map view. It's very easy, as you can see. It's just to have more control by your side. And also for the permission, it's the same situation of the location kit. About the push kit is very important for all the apps. We are really supporting push kit in every way because push kit is every time updating for each month with the new features and is a very stable solution. We are supporting by topic, by user token, but also we are supporting also by audience. If you are already integrating analytics kit from Huawei, you can create your audience and you can send the push notification to your audience. So it's very easy to integrate, it's very easy to use, it's very powerful because it will send notification also on background and on idle state of your app. And you know that with the recent updates of Android, the background, the limits, and so on, are something that we have to deal. So we are supporting also the server side for push notification. Just two web API, very easy. The first one is to get the access token. The second one, with the access token that you already got from the first API, you can send a push. And you can send a body very customized. We have a very good reference documented on our Huawei developer site with all the data structure, mandatory and optional fields. So you can create also condition into your body message. So you can create a condition through topics and also with tokens and both of them. Just for the client side, you just have to register a token. For a token, you just have to call the get token. The get token will generate the token the first time, only the first time, and then will return the token to you. But if you're using MIUI before 9.1, you have to extend also our service and override on your token. The first time you generate a token on that version, on those version of MIUI, you will check on your token method. On the recent version of MIUI, you can check the get token. So we suggest to use both of them, but it's very easy. And about the token, the only way to reset your token is to delete the app data. So the token is the existence is always in is forever in your app. And we are offering also our dashboard. There is no pricing for these services, no pricing at all. So you just go on our dashboard, just with your client side integrated, you can just send a push notification through our website, our dashboard. So you go on your console developer and then you can create the name of your push, and also title, description, custom buttons, and also the action, and a custom deep link if you want. Our push kit will manage both data message and notification message. Which is the difference? The difference is that the notification message is already managed from our push kit. It will create the UI by itself. You have to do nothing, only the registration of the topic or the token. It's up to you. About the data message will trigger our method in our service. And you will check that method and you will build your own message, your own notification through that method. So it's up to you. Just like I said before, we are giving to you all the choices. It's up to you what to choose. About the third-party notification services, there are a lot of third-party notification services that are cooperating with us, and the followings are already integrated HMS. So you can check if you're familiar with someone of these services, you can just update your library and follow its guideline, because in this way it's very easy to integrate the push kit. But you know that the third-party notification service is very useful because it's integrating more push notification services. So in this way you can choose what to use. And we're still integrating HMS with some other services. So this is are only the already integrated HMS. This is our most amazing, compelling kit, ML kit, machine learning kit. We have a lot of features and we are really supporting this kit, adding new features every month. We support text features just like text recognition, document recognition, and also bank card recognition, images, image recognition, voice language, just like text translation, language recognition, automatic speech recognition, and also face detection, skeleton detection, and detection. But you can customize also your model because we have MindSpore Lite. It's in our IDE. You can check through it the machine learning kit, and you can create your custom model. Then you can check if we're supporting cloud, standalone, or both of them. In most of cases, we support both of them. So just like text features are all standalone, and only bank card recognition is not on cloud. But you can check on our official documentation. This is an example of text recognition. This is an example text recognition from local and not from cloud. So you just have to get your local text analyzer and then setting your configuration. We're supporting a lot of languages, but in this example we are trying with English. And then you can get from the bitmap, you can get the results. But just one tip. If you want to scan barcode and some other codes, you need the scan kit, not confused with the machine learning kit. We have our scan kit, and with scan kit you can scan every code, and get results. About the automatic speech recognition, we are supporting two ways to integrate the automatic speech recognition: manage for you and manage from us. So just create your automatic speech recognition recognizer, and then if you want to use our UI, you just have to send an intent with specific parameters. If you will set feature word flags, it will get result also partial results. If you will set feature all in one, you will get only the complete results. The other way, without our UI, it's with another intent. This is an example of our UI method, and this is our UI dialogue. So, about text-to-speech. Text-to-speech currently is not supported through the manifest and Google API, Google API frameworks. So you have to integrate through our machine learning kit. And we are supporting a lot of languages. In this way, we are declaring only these languages, but we are supporting also Italian. And of course, you can set also the speaker voice, the person voice, female, male, or default, the speed and the volume. Just for our UpSup 2020 context, we have a hero case for automatic speech recognition and text-to-speech with our virtual assistant DataBot artificial intelligence. You can explore it on AppGallery. And is integrating also in AppPurchases. If you want to check also our demo projects, our sample, if you're looking for our sample, you just have to go on GitHub official HMS Core page. Just digit HMS Core. And you will find 65 repositories. They are open source repositories. You can do it your own pull request, your own edits, your own forks, for sure. And these are very complete samples. You can run it, and you can check it on your device, on also your on our cloud debugging, of course. And also we are writing articles, a lot of articles on our official Huawei Developers page on Medium. And also we have a forum, Huawei Developers Forum. If you have any kind of question, doubt, information, or also problems, issues, you can ask a question on this forum. We will answer. We have a lot of tools, as I said before, and we have also some IDE, just like the Mindspore Lite IDE for MLKit, but we have also the QuickApp IDE. What's a QuickApp? If you're familiar with InstantApp, it's very easy that you know the QuickApp. The QuickApp is a free installation app. So if you're choosing between app and QuickApp, it's wrong because you can have both of them, and you can have more QuickApps for the same apps. For the same app, QuickApps and apps are not strictly related between them. So you can we really suggest to have both of them. The quick app is low cost, of course. The first time I built a quick app, my first time was 15 minutes. I spent only 15 minutes. It's with JavaScript and CSS. I know that JavaScript is just like an evil for a lot of developers, but it's very easy to use. Then, as I said, it's without consuming storage because it's a free install. It's just like a shortcut, and you can also integrate our kits through Quick Apps. But also from the Quick App, you can create your own web link, so you can redirect to a web page. It's very easy. When you create a sample with our Quick App IDE, it will create a sample project for you, and just with a web link. So you just have to replace the web link. And also, if you want to send a user agent to set a user agent, you can. It's very easy. But we are not supporting only Quick App. Beyond our apps and quick apps, we have also Huawei Ability Gallery. As Alessandro yesterday said in his very detailed introduction for HMS World, the Huawei Ability Gallery is very compelling feature. It's on minus one page of your Huawei phone. It's only on Huawei phone and currently is only supported from enterprise developers. But in future, we are scheduling for individual developers. And we have a lot of categories for Ability Galleries, just like shopping, food, flight, but also taxi. And we have iTaxi for an Italian example, and also Giallo Zafferano for Cardability. Just to explain, we have three kinds of Ability Gallery: Appability, Content Ability, and Cardability. So the app ability is just like a shortcut for your app, and it will be a fast link for the user to go to your app. Then Content Ability is just like to provide data from your backend. Just to explain more, the Ability Gallery is not related to your app. There's no a connection between your app and the ability. These are two different ways, two different features. So the ability is a tab on our console developer, different from the app. And it's not communicating with the apps. So it's just communicating with your backend. If you're using a content ability, the app ability is only a dashboard configuration, nothing more. No needs a developer for that. For content ability, cardability needs a developer. Cardability is the most compelling, most amazing feature through the ability gallery, and it's just like that. You will see all the card. The user can check all the preferred services. Also, if the app is not installed on his device, don't worry because the service is here. So the user can check it and can use it. And he will get all the feeds from you. And you can customize your card as you want. You're very free to do all what you want. So, from me, it's all. These are a lot of contacts to contact me. If you have doubts, questions, if you want information, if you want a meeting with me in order to provide solution for your apps, don't worry, ask me. And also, if you're not in Italy, no problem. We have a local team for each country, so I can redirect to the local team. Okay. And about Medium, I wrote several articles also for the badge, because through our console developer, you can create your app badge in an easy way. And no needs a developer for that. And also GitHub for my sample and so on. About today, I suggest to follow, to attend the Marco Porcaro's talk from Synesthesia, because he will explain how to use both GMS and HMS in your project. So thank you.